Humble boy who never needed much, but as he approached his teenage years, he felt disconnected from his ancestors, the ones from the stories his family passed down from generation to generation. He felt empty and lost and a stranger in this country he was born in, but never fully felt a part of. He knew something was missing. And so he decides to embark on a journey that he hopes will give him the answers he needs. One day, he borrowed his dad's canoe and set out into the Pacific Ocean, excited for the adventure, but having no clue where to start. He knew there was much to learn and hoped he would be guided by those gone before him. After a week of traveling and surrounded by ocean, the sun rose to reveal a long, white cloud. As he drifted closer and closer, he heard lovely, sweet voices coming from Aotearoa.
I love you, Davey! Hey, Timmy the Smurf!
Yeah.
Including the obligation to care for people and environment, a gift and something for Tama to remember this part of him. He would wear it with pride. Ready to leave, they press noses and take a deep breath in, signifying they are one and strangers no more. The voices echo in Tama's ears as he looks back and savours this moment. He remembers his family, his mother, his father, and the sacrifices they made to create a life full of opportunity for him and his brothers and sisters in a new land, the land he was born in. Tama's story is one of many, a story of yours, a story of mine, one whose families have travelled by boat or plane to enter the unknown, the unfamiliar, all with the hope of a better life. Tama represents the confusion, the sometimes feelings of disconnect that can happen as two identities are united. Tama looks out to the wide open ocean ahead of him, knowing that although he had this piece, there was still more out there to be found. Armed with a little more confidence, Tama gets back on his canoe and sets out once again on his journey in search of what he was looking for, but still not knowing what that was. After many more days of being tossed upon the Pacific Ocean, Tama washes on the shores of the friendly islands of Tonga. He is welcomed by bright smiles, with arms wide open, and instantly feels home.
Go, Davey!
Go, Hola!
Can you turn the music off?
Oh, marijuana.
He's still amazed that he's able to find his way and wasn't sure where to go next. But just like that, the wind picked up and guided him to the northeast. Sailing for only a few days this time, he soon spots smoke rising into the air, accompanied by the mouth-watering smells of cooked umu. Welcome to the heart of Polynesia, Samoa.
Tell him a hoot off.
Alrighty.
Yeah, take it off anyway. Get out of there.
Come on, man. It's so hot.
Double down.
This guy wants to hold you.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, boy.
Mama.
Hola.
Come on.
Yeah, lovely. Yeah,
Mama.
Yeah, Mama. Ricky.
Mama.
Everyone's waiting.
Hey, Sandy. We were hot.
Oh.
Davy.
No, son.
Maria Davy.
Davy.
Bustling day. The Ulafala is presented to him, worn by chiefs and heads of families, representing communities, villages, and districts. He too wears this with pride. Having collected a variety of items that represent his identity and where he has come from, Tama feels grateful and appreciative for all he has experienced the past couple of weeks. Suddenly, it dawns on him, and in his heart of hearts, he knows exactly where he needs to go next. For the first time, he feels full, and not just from the food. He sets his sail toward home, to a land that is more than 3,000 million years old. The land his family felt to settle in and raise a family with others. A land now one fair and free. Womanjeka. Upon arrival, he is embraced by the land he was born in. A land occupied by a people for more than 65,000 years. All this time he had been searching for the missing pieces of himself, searching for what seemed lost, and finally realized that we are not separated by land, we are connected by the ocean, the reefs, and the sky. He was home.
Yeah, Glen Eagles! Go holla! Yeah, holla! Yeah, the boys!